Hello everyone, this is Dennis and you are on the Den Electro channel. Today I want to talk about such a concept as voltage drop on a diode. From a school physics course, everyone knows that diodes have different voltage drops. All these figures are very averaged and taken only so that you can sleep peacefully. In fact, everything is much more complicated. The voltage drop on a diode depends on the current passing through it. The greater the current, the greater the voltage drop. Let's figure out whether this is good or bad. The voltage drop itself cannot be attributed to a bad or good property of diodes. In some cases, it helps to extinguish excess voltage, from several hundred millivolts if you use ordinary diodes, to several tens of volts if you take Zener diodes. Also, very often, this property of diodes is used as a reference voltage. In other cases, when we use diodes as rectifiers, this property of diodes brings only problems. With a large voltage drop and high current, the diodes heat up very much. Let's conduct a test on dual Schottky diodes S30 SC 4 meters. It is designed for 40 volts, 30 amperes, but each of the diodes can withstand only 15 amperes. I will check only one diode. If the multimeter has a diode test function, then it is very easy to measure the voltage drop. I apply the negative probe of the multimeter to the cathode and the positive to the anode. It shows only 96 millivolts. However, this will only be the initial voltage. The voltage drop that occurs at approximately 10 milliamperes. To find out how the diode behaves at high currents, you need to assemble a small circuit. Behind the scenes, I connected the load. The current will be supplied to it through the diode. This multimeter will show the current through the load, and this one will show the voltage drop across the diode. Don't pay attention to these diodes for now, we'll get to them later. First, I set the current to 1 amp. The voltage drop was 306 millivolts. I increased the current further, I set it to 2 amp. The voltage drop becomes more than 330 millivolts. With a current of 3 amp, the drop is 345 millivolts. With 4 amp, 357 millivolts. And with 5 amp, 368 millivolts. From this experiment, it becomes clear that the more current flows through the diode, the greater the voltage drop on it becomes. To find out what the voltage drop will be on this diode at its maximum 15 amp, it is not necessary to make your own measurements and load it up to 15 amp. This information can be found in the documentation for this diode assembly. There is a graph with a volt-ampere characteristic. It can be used to find out what voltage will drop across the diode when a certain current passes through. Let me explain how to find out. The horizontal axis shows the voltage drop, and the vertical axis shows the current passing through the diode. The two dotted lines show the voltage drop at a temperature of 150 degrees, and the two solid lines show the voltage drop at a temperature of 25 degrees. Two values are shown for each temperature, typical and maximum. This is due to the fact that there are no two identical diodes. They can always have a discrepancy in parameters. You can find out the voltage drop at a certain current as follows. Let's say I am interested in a current of 1 ampere. First, I find this mark on the horizontal line. I follow it until it meets the black line. From the place where they intersect, I draw an imaginary vertical line and go down. Here will be the approximate voltage drop on the diode. If you look at the left strip, at the typical value, with a current of 1 ampere, the voltage drop should be slightly more than 0.3 volts, approximately 325 millivolts. If I am interested in a current of 2 amperes, then look above. Here the voltage drop will be approximately 360 millivolts. I also tracked all the other currents and compared them with my measurements. My readings turned out to be approximately 10% less than those indicated in the datasheet. They turned out to be less than not only the maximum, but also the typical ones. Most likely, this is due to inaccurate measuring devices, a voltmeter and ammeter. In addition, the diode assembly may be a fake or produced in violation of the production technology. Well, my last theory is related to the temperature at which the measurements were taken. Please note the graph. At a temperature of 150 degrees, the voltage drop across the diodes is almost 2 times less than at a temperature of 25 degrees. When current is passed through the diode, it naturally begins to heat up, even if it is on a radiator. Because of this, measurements may differ even with precise measuring instruments. In general, all these nuances affect the measurements, and therefore, when you look at the dashed on your diode, you do not need to look for exact matches with your readings there. Let's go back to the dashed again and look at the top of the graph. We want to know what losses we will have at maximum current. At a current of 14 amperes, the voltage drop on the diode will be 0.8 volts. This is quite a lot. 8 times more than the initial voltage drop. And 2.5 times more than a current of 1 ampere. But at a current of 10 amperes, a drop of only 0.5 volts is still quite tolerable. Different diodes, even if they are all Schottky diodes, can also have different voltage drops. My measurements are written down here with the datasheets. They also do not match up a little. These are the diodes that I checked now. This is a single diode for 100 volts, 5 amps. And these are, again, dual diodes for 200 volts, 20 amps. One diode naturally holds only 10 amps. From all this, we can assume that the higher the diode's operating current, the lower its voltage drop. But at the same time, its maximum operating voltage decreases. If the power supply voltage is 5.10 volts, then you can use the first option. Even if the current consumption is only 2 amperes, we can save twice as much energy and reduce heat generation. If the power supply voltage is higher, then we will have to take other diodes, but the voltage drop will most likely be higher there. The drop on silicon diodes is even greater. Let's look at the Soviet diode, 2D213A. It can withstand a voltage of 200 volts and a current of 10 amps. Here are the results of its test. Compared to its closest analog, the Schottky diode, the voltage drop here is greater, from 70 to 100 millivolts, but in terms of maximum current, everything is very deplorable. Judging by the datasheet graph, at a current of 10 amps, the voltage drop will be 1 volt. While on MBR20100CT diodes at 10 amperes, the voltage drop will be only 750 millivolts. Since in this video I am talking about the voltage drop on diodes, I would like to add a little about the thermal power released by them. Let's take the last diode 2D213 for example. At a current of 10 amperes, 1 volt of voltage drops on it. If we multiply these numbers, we get 10 watts of released thermal power. But this is only on the condition that the current through it is constant. If we rectify alternating current in the form of a sine wave or square wave, then in the intervals between half periods, the diode will cool down. Therefore, the thermal power released on it will not be 10 watts, but 2 times less. That's all for today. Like, subscribe to the channel, and bye everyone.